Let's make bouncy balls. First of all, tell the computer what a ball is. A ball has a position, velocity, radius, and color. Tell the computer that you can draw a ball by setting the color and then make an ellipse with the ball's position onto the diameter, which is twice the radius. Make a ball variable before setup, and make the ball inside setup. Make the ball have a nice position inside the canvas, a small random velocity, a nice radius, and of course a random color. Now in draw, execute ball.draw. Restart a few times to see some nice randomness. Problem 1. The ball isn't moving. Go back to the ball class and make a move function. Then add the ball's velocity to the ball's position. Then move the ball before drawing. Nice, the ball's moving. Problem 2. The ball goes outside of the screen. Go back to the move function and add a check for the left side of the canvas. If the check triggers, move the ball back inside the canvas and flip the velocity. Do the same for the right side and then copy-paste all of that to make it for the y-axis as well. You can edit multiple things at once by holding Ctrl while selecting them. But the ball now bounces at the center point, which is no good, so don't forget to add or subtract the radius to the ball checks. Looking good, but it's a bit spacey. Problem 4, there's no gravity. To add gravity, go back to move and add a nice number to the y velocity. That was easy, look at the bouncy ball. Problem 4, just a single ball is boring. Let's add more balls. First, turn the single ball into a list of balls. Next, have loops in setup and draw. Interesting, but we forgot something. Problem 5, the balls face through each other. Let's add a collide function. Don't collide with yourself, that's stupid. Get the relative position from this ball to the other ball, and get the distance by getting the magnitude of the relative and subtracting the radii. Now check if we are actually colliding. If so, give the ball some personal space. Do this by taking a copy of the relative vector and setting its length to half the distance, and make sure it's a positive number with the absolute function. Now subtract the momentum from this and add it to the other. Back in draw, make a loop with variable I that goes from 0 to the amount of balls. And in that loop, make another loop with variable j that goes from 0 to I. Now collide ball I with ball j. Nice, but they don't bounce. First, get a copy of the relative position and make it length 1 by normalizing it. Next, calculate the approach speed using the dot products of our new vector. And then use the approach speed on relative positions to calculate the full approach vector. This is basically the relative direction and speed at which the balls are going to each other. Now subtract the approach vector from this velocity and add it to the other velocity. Oh, and spell normalize with a Z. Look at these bouncy balls. Maybe try adding some mouse interaction, random ball sizes, ball images, and whatever you want. The code is in the description and you can just start editing it. It'll be saved to your P5 account even if you use my link.